So we want to understand how a program is compiled into assembly code. Okay, so let's start with this very, very simple one. Okay, and I will just show you the whole process. So I need to share with you the screen again. And fire up my command tools, minimize it a little bit. Okay, right. And let's get to the directory where is the directory of this thing. Okay, it has to be embedded. Okay, so let's see where we are. Okay, so we go directly there. We go to embed 29 and see what it is. Okay, so this is the platform we will use. You can get the whole source code, including the one that run in macOS. Okay, I just recompiled it during the weekend and it works. Okay, and okay, so let's go to example for today. Okay, inside here we have our usual okay, all right. So let's try very simple program first. The program with one line, maybe two lines. Okay, just main A equals 0. Let's make it bigger. Okay. Right, and call this main. It has to be in the right place. So let's put it here. Call it main. Boom. Okay, now we have the code. And oh, we just have to assemble it. Go. So let's go assemble main plus text. Whoa, symbol A. Oh, I see. No, this is a high level, so I have to use my compiler to compile first. Sorry. Okay. All right. And yeah, it give out the matching code. Let's put it in the file. Out text and let's see that file. Out.txt here. Let's make it bigger. Now from just one line of high level program, you can see a lot of machine code being produced. If we really go into that one line, the main body of the program will be translated just here. Okay, so this line, it just move 0 to local variable. For what is for the rest, let's just ignore the top, right? Leave out the comment. Okay. And just send it out.
And you have the address. Hello. Here. เฮ้ยมึงคือกูตามไม่ทันเว้ยกูไปเข้าน้ำมาแล้วตอน 9:10 เลยสักพักหนึ่ง 9:15 เขาสอนแล้วไอ้สัตว์กูกลับมา 9:20
โอเคOkay, so we leave everything out, then program become less confusing to see. We ignore the top part first. Let's concentrate on this one line program. Today we have to understand this portion, which create the what we call a runtime. Runtime record, okay. And this is a data structure that is used to save all the register in your program where.A subroutine has been called or a function has been called, because in a subroutine you are going to use the same set as register at the main program. So before so without knowing which register the main program is used.You have to save the register which you are going to use before you use it, and after you finish with the body of your function, you have to restore that register back, okay, and then return to the main program. Okay, so we are going to explain this.This morning, okay. Let's go back to our lecture. So, in short, the program start with the location zero. It go through a bit of setting up the value in the register. I will explain this shortly, and then it call the main program. All right. Once the main program return.This is the main program. Once the main program finish, it's returned, and then our simulation will stop. This is the code produced from high-level language, which come from just these two lines. Okay. In order to understand this kind of function calling each other, we have to know this portion, what it look like in the memory first.Okay, so I think I will draw a picture for you to see. Let me use my mobile phone as another camera to show my drawing. Okay.Join with video. Wait for a while. Now, let's start the video. And what? Oh yeah, I have seen. So, let me share you the teacher from how to how to share pin the video. Okay, let's see. Okay, I hope everyone can see my camera. Okay, let's do it like this. Okay. Let's say we have main function and it's called program A, and in program A it called program B. Okay, let's see what happened. Let's see the memory grow from top to bottom. This is we call the frame, which is stored in the RAM. So main program will have one frame, we call main, and then we have to know where this is, so we use the frame pointer here. Okay, once the main executed, these data will be created to keep the value of the register as necessary. When the main call function A, the stack grow, so this is the frame of function A, and the frame pointer moves to here very simply. And when function A call function B, it grow again to the frame of function B, right? Once the B finish, it will look like this. Main frame of A and B will be deleted with the frame pointer coming back to A. So this is how the will be called runtime frame. Okay, let's call it frame. The actual technical term we call activation record. Okay, this is the actual term. So what is within the frame? It keep register, that's all. Okay. The number of register or the size of this frame is known when we compile our program. Okay. All right. Now we thought of seeing how the frame is created and deleted. Okay, let's see what kind of code could do that. We use two instruction, right, with the addressing with the offset, okay, which is written down like this, with the displacement as a small offset to the main work of relative to the frame pointer. So R2 in this line will be used as a frame pointer, okay? As we know, everything that can store value in a processor, just register, so they don't have anything else, they just have register. They can store this value temporarily in the memory, right? So that how we what we call we can do. You might be wondering why we have to keep all the register. Let's say A called B. Anything that has been used in the function A will be stored in register. Of course, some part of it may be stored in the memory, but we are worrying about register. So when A call B, anything in B we also use the same register. Okay, so before we start to do the work, it's better save all the register from A, right? Temporary into this frame, and then it can do its work, and then restore this register back and delete that frame when it returns. Okay, so we use these two instructions. So let's simplify that and see this one line program of us. The body is here. So before we begin, let's say main is just one function. Okay, so just like the other. We have used this frame pointer. Frame pointer also be assigned to a register, which is a global. It means this value had to be kept all the time. Okay, so it have to be safe, because the when we call the next, the value of frame pointer have to be restored, as you have seen, right? And the we should not use frame pointers for, this is a global register, so we should not use this register for something else in our program. Otherwise, you just destroy all the data structure at runtime. So first thing, we main program has one local variable, which is a register, which is the name A. We keep it in register number one. So we save register number one, okay, at one slot, and then change. Oh, right. Okay, so I have to finish within 10 minutes, and we have a small break about 10 minutes and come back again, okay? And then we shift the frame pointer to the amount of the size of the frame, and within the frame, one that we have to keep is the return address. When one program call another program, it have to keep the return address in register. We call this register actually the link register. Okay, so in this example, we call return address register. So we keep it in the frame as well. And you can see when we delete the frame, we do exactly the reverse. We store return address, we save return address, and then we restore return address, and then we move the frame back and restore register one, and then return. Okay. So I already draw you the picture. So let's move on to see if we have two functions. Let's say I have asked you to write this program as a homework last week. Main will call function double, okay, we also include passing one parameter. And let's see how the frame is created and deleted. Okay. Let's see in the function double first, the main body is just here. Okay, it's a get the actual parameter from the stack. Okay, and then it do adding, and then it return the value into another kind of global register we call return value. Okay, it is when you return anything from a function, it will be kept in this register so that the caller know where to get the value from the function it called. So this is how it created the frame. It have two value in the function double. One is the x, and the other one is temporary when it adds x together. Okay, so it used two register here. therefore it's safe to register before you use it, and then create a frame and then store the return address there. Actually, if the function do not call another function, then it won't destroy, it will not destroy the return address, right? But we save it, we save it just in case we call another function from the function double, right? And once it finish its work, it just restore the value and delete the frame. You don't have to worry about this much because this sequence of code has been produced by a compiler. Okay, we just have to be able to recognize it and understand what happened. How we pass the actual parameter to a function. So we push them, this is already known, okay, and then we jump and link or call the double, right, with this register as a link register. Okay, right. So in this example, the frame of the actual program is running. When it's run to function double, it will have the memory growing from the top to bottom, look like this. Okay, main store two register, and the double store three register. So, okay. Finally, I will show you a little bit more complex program of accessing the array. We know how to write it by hands, but we just show you how the compiler produced the code for this thing. So the program will be just one line again of storing some value into an array. And the compiler will allocate the array. Okay, we as a programmer, we don't have to worry about that. Okay, but we have to know how to set the compiler to allocate the memory at the correct place. Okay. In our compiler, it is default at the, I think it start at the 1000. Okay, the memory 1000. You can change that in the compiler as well. So it used this kind of addressing to and this kind of symbol to produce the code that correctly access the array. Okay.